हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी सैम्पलिंग प्रोसेस इन डिटेल विद डिफरेंट एग्जांपल्स इन ईच पॉइंट। फर्स्ट लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड मीनिंग ऑफ सैम्पलिंग। सैम्पलिंग इज द प्रोसेस ऑफ सिलेक्टिंग यूनिट्स फ्रॉम अ पॉपुलेशन ऑफ इंटरेस्ट, सो दैट बाय एग्जामिनिंग अ सैम्पल वी कैन फेयरली जनरलाइज अवर रिजल्ट बैक टू द पॉपुलेशन फ्रॉम विच दे वर सिलेक्टेड। फॉलोइंग स्टेप्स इन सैम्पलिंग वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी इन डिटेल। Step number 1. Defining the target population. The population must be properly and accurately defined. If the population is improper, the research will answer wrong question. It is vital to accurately define the target population. In this way, the proper source from which the data should be calculated can be determined. The question, to whom do we want to talk, must be answered. This can be users, non-users, newly hired employees, doctors, housewives, etc. For example, if a kitchen appliance company wants to conduct a survey to find out the demand for its microwave ovens, it may define the population as all women over the age of 20 who prepare food and whose monthly household income exceeds 20,000 rupees. This reduces the size of the target population and makes the research more focused. Step number 2. Identify sampling frame. Once the definition of the population is clear, the researcher must decide on the sampling frame. A sampling frame is the list of elements from which the sample may be drawn. Typically, researchers use readily available sampling frames like telephone directories, list of credit card, and mobile phone users. Sometimes, maps and aerial photographs are also used as sampling frame. Whatever may be the case, an ideal frame is one in which each element appears in the list separately, once and only once, and nothing else appears on the list. For example, if your target group is professional employee at work, because you cannot access all professional staff around the world, a more realistic sampling frame would be a list of employees from one or two local companies who are willing to participate in your research. Step number 3. Specify sampling units. A sampling unit is a basic unit that contains a single element or a group of elements of the population to be sampled. It may contain geographical area like a state, a city, social units like family, club, school, store, organization, etc. For example, Revlon wants to access consumer response to new line of lipsticks and can sample women over the age of 18 who live in specific society. In this example, society is sampling unit and sampling element is women over the age of 18. Step number 4. Selecting sampling method. The sampling method determines how the sampling units are selected. The choice of sampling method is influenced by the goal of the business research, the availability of the financial resources, time constraint, and the nature of the problem under study. All sampling methods can be divided into two groups, that is probability and non-probability sampling. You can refer my video of type of sampling methods by clicking suggested link above. Step number 5. Determination of sample size. This refers to the numbers of items that must be selected from the universe in order to compose the sample. Sample size should not be excessively large or too small. An optimal sample is one that meets the requirement for efficiency, representativeness, reliability, and flexibility. Resource constraint should be considered when deciding on sample size. The required sample size should be adjusted for the number of eligible participants and the degree of completion. For example, if you want to know about dog owners, you include everyone who has ever had at least one dog. You can include or exclude those who have owned a dog in the past depending on the objective of your research. Step number 6. Specify the sampling plan. At this stage, The specification and decisions regarding the implementation of the sampling process is outlined. The sampling plan will define the sampling units, provides instruction for the interviewer on how to take samples, give advice on what to do if no one is at home, etc. All these and many other questions need to be answered for the smooth functioning of the sampling process. Step number 7. Selecting the sample. This is the last step in the sampling process, where the actual sampling of the elements is performed. At this stage, it is necessary that the interviewer stick to the rules outlined for the smooth implementation of sampling. This step involves implementing a sampling plan to select the sample required for the survey. Friends, thank you for watching my video. If you like my video, then please subscribe to my channel Management by Dr. Mitul Dhimmer and share my videos. Thank you.